In Somalia, we saw something magic happening, which was seeing all FAO working together for one goal, which was fighting starvation of people in bad times during a famine. And FAO came out great. We've been a super applauded organization, everybody loving us, government, people, partners, just because we were working great. From the director general to the guards in this building, everybody was partnering with us to make it happening. And it was an incredible, pleasant success, because it was not a success of one person or a small team, it was the success of FAO. One great goal, a lot of people engaging. The director general came in the first 30 days of his new mandate. Everybody was there to support us to deliver what we need to deliver. And that made the FAO the biggest agency, the biggest office of FAO in the world was in Somalia, and is in Somalia. And it make us being the second agency in Somalia and being extremely appreciated by the government and by the people in Somalia. We are the only UN agency which can access any part of Somalia, being in conflict and being out of of any area, government or non-government.
Our greatest achievement has been to engage with women. We work in a very conservative tribal area on the border of Afghanistan, and women's lives are very much circumscribed by local traditions. We have had a commitment in the project to 40% of our community organizations being women only. And we've had enormous benefit in this, in changing women's lives on a day-to-day basis. Not in a way that threatens society, but allows the women to come together as a group, to share issues and concerns, and that we can then, through our own women community development and marketing facilitators, get some technology into them to produce some eggs for the family through a poultry program, to improve livestock management, because women handle a lot of livestock issues, and to improve family nutrition through a kitchen garden program. And we are looking to add further value in that through livestock, to improve the value of wool, which is a under-appreciated resource. There's 12 million sheep in Balochistan, and the wool is currently very low value.
I'm very happy with the sustained work that we've done in the region, but one of the projects that I'm most satisfied with is an initiative that we had in the Philippines to introduce low-cost, simple approaches to regenerating degraded forest land. And we introduced what we call assisted natural regeneration, which promotes the growth of natural seedlings and saplings native to areas by controlling unplanned fires and grazing, and helping these natural seedlings to grow at very low cost, about half of what conventional reforestation has been.